In today's video, we look at a study conducted on the Wim Hof Method to understand how the technique can be expected to affect the body and specifically how the method can be used in reaction to external sources of illness or bacteria. The video comes after I looked into a study conducted at Radboud University back in 2015, whereby they were looking to see how the training program consisting of meditation, breathing exercises, and cold exposure influenced the response to endotoxin administration, and specifically how the participants' mindsets influenced the results. The idea behind the study was to understand what could be expected when healthy men, though it isn't limited to one gender, practiced the Wim Hof method and were then faced with the experimentally induced inflammation. So, what was factored into the test? As with any research conducted, numerous factors and variables were taken into consideration as part of this research. This considered both psychological and physical response to the endotoxin, to try and establish how much of the effect was coming from using the techniques. The main psychological factor considered was the potential placebo effects, as this would help us understand whether it was the technique that was actually resulting in the response, or whether people felt they were responding better and thus their body reacted as such. Not just this, but also the key element was that how much did the expectancy of the participants play a role in the autoimmune response. In terms of physiology, all participants in the study were tested to see their health and fitness, with blood samples taken to evaluate other health-related factors. What data was collected? As those conducting the study were primarily interested in the specific effects of the outcome expectancies on the response to the endotoxin administration after training, they focused their efforts on finding the effects of the training and felt it could only meaningfully be assessed in the trained group. Analysis was performed on the trained group that underwent the endotoxin administration only, meaning there weren't any other groups studied. During the tests, variables were screened for deviations from normality and changes in specific outcome expectancies from before the training to after. The experiment was explored by means of analysis of variance, meaning they could catch any anomalies. What was found? Overall, as had been suspected for young healthy men, those in the trained groups were overall optimistic and low in neuroticism, meaning they were relaxed and not feeling stressed. With regard to the specific outcome expectancies, participants showed an increase in the expected effects of the training on their response to endotoxin administration and health from before the training to after the experiment, meaning that there were signs of improvement in the immune response after using the Wim Hof method. This is particularly important to understand and note, as it could go a long way in explaining how we can better control the autoimmune response to sickness, meaning we can recover faster. Comparing the expected versus outcome. So the test was expecting us to see some improvement on using the Wim Hof method, but what was unknown was what factors played a role in this improvement, and specifically how our psychology influences the outcome. What's interesting is that a higher degree of optimism was associated with adrenaline levels and IL-10 levels, the latter being an anti-inflammatory cytokine. This basically means that with the effects of the Wim Hof method, people were more quickly able to combat sickness. What's also important to note is neuroticism was not significantly associated with the response to endotoxin administration, but a more positive expectation of the effects of the training was associated with a lower flu-like clinical symptom report, meaning participants weren't stressed, but rather optimistic about what could be achieved. So what does this actually mean? Simply put, there is a correlation between practicing the Wim Hof method and seeing an improved autoimmune response to endotoxins, which are extremely positive signals. The mental effects of practicing the Wim Hof method also had a direct influence on stress and immune system functioning in the body, with greater optimism showing greater results. And this is extremely unique to the test, as while other tests checked to see the efficacy of the Wim Hof method, few checked how our psychology plays a role. While those conducting the test have said that further analysis with a larger sample size is necessary, the signs are positive about the effects of practicing the Wim Hof method. And the key is understanding it's not just about the physical benefits either. but rather also how important your mindset is in your health. How much focus do you place on your mindset in life? Let me know in the comments section below. Please like, share, and subscribe as we help you live life on your terms. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to ensure YouTube notifies you of the latest uploads. Thanks for watching.